गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. माय नेम इज डॉक्टर गरिमा कौशिक, सेकेंड ईयर रेजिडेंट फ्रॉम डॉक्टर डीवाई पाटिल मेडिकल कॉलेज एंड रिसर्च सेंटर. टुडे आई विल बी प्रेजेंटिंग एन अनयूजुअल प्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ एन एक्रोमियन लेशन अंडर द गाइडेंस ऑफ प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर पूर्ण चंद्र लांगरे. अ 42-year-old मेल प्रेजेंटेड विद पेन इन राइट शोल्डर सिंस 3 months. शोल्डर एक्सरे शोड एविडेंस ऑफ एन इल डिफाइंड सस्पिशियस स्क्लेरोटिक लेशन इन द एक्रोमियन प्रोसेस ऑन एपी एंड द एक्चुअल व्यूज. Since there is a suspicious sclerotic lesion in the scapula, the patient is complaining of right shoulder pain. MRI was suggested for the further evaluation. These are the T2 and STIR weighted images which show hyperintensity involving acromion process with possible cortical breach and soft tissue lesion. Further, T1, T2 and STIR coronal images show altered signal intensity in the acromion process with a soft tissue component within. Based on these MRI findings, possibility of a lesion most likely metastatic needs consideration. Ultrasound of abdomen, neck and scrotum appear to be normal. Further, chest X-ray was performed. In the chest X-ray, we can see right hilum appears prominent with a suspicious radio opacity involving right suprahilar region. These are the CT lung window images, axial sections in which a soft tissue density lesion can be seen in the posterior segment of the right upper lobe with speculated margins. Also, we can see there are no obvious calcifications within. CT bone window shows an ill-defined lytic lesion with partial sclerotic rim in the acromion process of the scapula. CT bone window revealed axial and sagittal images showing lytic lesion with a cortical break involving left pedicle of lower thoracic vertebra. Further, PET CT was advised to the patient, which revealed significant FDG uptake in the acromion process of the right scapula. PET CT images showed significant FDG uptake in the right lung field involving the posterior segment of the right upper lobe. Further, histopathology was advised, in which biopsy was taken from the lung lesion, which came out to be adenocarcinoma of the lung. Biopsy of the acromion lesion was also performed, which found out to be metastasis from the lung lesion. Coming to the discussion, bone is the third most common site for metastasis, surpassed only by lung and liver. Lytic bone metastases are seen in a number of malignancies such as lung carcinoma, thyroid carcinoma, renal cell carcinoma, adrenal gland carcinoma, uterine carcinoma, GI carcinoma, and Wilms' tumor. Most common sites of skeletal metastasis from carcinoma lung are spine, ribs, ileum, sacrum, and femur. Very few cases of bone metastasis to humerus, scapula, and sternum have been reported. Case presented here is unique as acromion metastasis has not been described. Bone scintigraphy detects sclerotic lesion, whereas FDG CT PET can detect bone lytic and sclerotic lesion. Thus, FDG CT PET is considered superior to scintigraphy. Take-home message: metastasis should be included in differentials in patients presenting with bone lesions. Even in young patient, follow the golden rule of radiology. Once a pathology is detected, do not stop there. Search for other subtle lesions as it may change the plan of treatment and management. These are the references. Thank you.